Hello. Good morning and welcome. Happy Christmas, nearly. Happy Christing or service. If you have a coffee, would you like to come and find a seat? It's a little bit laid out differently this morning. But grab, if you are happy with these nice little seats, the nice little round seats, come and grab a nice little round seat. If you would like a little bit more social distancing, on the left, my right, the outsides here, there are little tables. You can come and sit out in pairs or on singles. If you need some extra room just outside, please do grab them. For now, just grab your coffee, come and join us, and we'll start in a few minutes. Thank you. My name's Duncan, for those of you who don't know me. If you are here today for the first time, you are so, so welcome. I hope you enjoy it with us. This is set up a little bit different to what we do normally, but I'm sure you'll enjoy it. if you're on the live stream this morning, welcome. For whatever reason, we're so glad you could join us. Welcome at the back. Come and find a seat. It's a little bit different. There's a few more seats on this side. If you still not found a seat yet, there are still a few if you want to sit slightly socially distanced on my left and my right. Thank you all of you for bringing your masks. I hope you like my Christmas mask this morning, especially bought for these. Gosh, where do we start? Just for information, we've left the doors open. If you need to put a jacket on, it's because we've left the doors open just to make sure there's a nice throughput of air. All those little things we can do to keep COVID at bay is always a good thing. For those of us who are speaking or singing, we'll take our masks off, but if you are exempt, of course, from wearing a mask, you do not need to. And equally, if you are 11 or under, but if you're, sorry, it's 11 or over, that'd be nice to wear a mask if you don't mind. Sonia, can you just tell us, come and tell us what we're doing next week, and then I'll talk about this week.
Yes. Okay, so next week is our no rehearsal nativity carol extravaganza. So what that means is we will be telling the story of Jesus' birth, and you are all going to get involved. If you don't want to, you can sit and watch everybody else being involved. You can sit and you can just relax and watch and hopefully laugh and enjoy it. But if you are so inclined to dress up as something from the Nativity, like a king or an angel or a donkey or a baby Jesus or a star, that's grown-ups as well as children, please do. And we will all be joining in for that. There will be mulled wine, non-alcoholic, and mince pies, and hopefully some singing of carols and lots of fun.
Fantastic.
Did that?
Thank you very much. Be here. It will be amazing. We're very much looking forward to it. For those of you who don't like new things, sorry about the different setup this morning. I'll come on to that in a minute, but you've got bags on your tables and everything. It'll all make sense. I promise you won't get there. So next week, Sonny just talked about, the week after, the Sunday after that is Boxing Day. There is no service. We're not allowed in the room. It's really simple. And then the week after that, the 2nd of January, again, we can't tie the hall, so there's no service. But on the 2nd of January, we will do a nice walk around Horton Country Park, where we can tell each other what a wonderful Christmas we had, or whinge about what happened with our relatives. For those of you who's brought stuff for the hampers, if you look straight behind the AV desk, that nice pile of goodies at the back, those are our Christmas hampers that we're going to give out this. We're going to, Simon and Merrill's life group are going to make those this week on Thursday. If you've got anything, if you can pop it on the table at the back. If you are still to donate, if you can actually speak to Merrill, it's probably the easiest way, and just work out how you can get things to them, that'd be great. We did hampers last year, and it was just for those, particularly for the people that we have helped in the past. So when we've done gardens for people, when we've done decorating for people, we just want to keep those connections going. Anyone who needs a little bit of help and support at Christmas, it's kind of what we do. It's been nice. Right. Okay, in a minute, we've got Paul and Sonia are going to come up, and we're going to have a few songs with the band. Hopefully there's a bit of room. If you want to spread out a little bit more, you can. They will be at least a couple of metres away from you singing, hopefully. Hopefully. if you are so inclined, there are some shaky eggs on this table here. Would you like to shake one? There you go. If you would like to shake, if you are of a younger age or a younger disposition and would like to grab a shaky egg and join in with the worship, like Chloe's showing us now, you are more than welcome. after we've sung worship together, Lorna's going to take us through making Christingles together. Now, for me, Christingles is Christmas. When I was about that big, I went with my grandparents to their really old church in the middle of Worcestershire, and we made a Christingle, and I was like, this is great. And so for me, there is a certain amount of the essence of Christmas when we make Christingles together. Lorna will explain it all later. There are bags on your tables. Do be careful. There are sharp things in the bags. We use cocktail sticks, essentially, so there are some pointy things. So maybe adults get the things out and distribute. That would be great. But you don't need them just yet. Da-da-da-da. Right. If you are watching on the live stream, I should say, if you've got an apple or an orange, some cocktail sticks, some dried fruit or sweets, some red tape or ribbon, and maybe a candle, maybe even a birthday candle you can stick in the top of your orange or apple, then you can join in with that too. If you've got a few minutes when we're singing songs and things, if you want to go and grab those. Cool. If you haven't got them, please do stay with us. We're just so grateful you've joined us. Right. I'm going to pray, and then we'll worship together with a couple of songs. Lord, we just invite your presence here this morning. We thank you. We thank you for the Advent season as we draw into remembering your birth. And Lord, will you just turn our hearts to you this morning. Remind us of the joy that we can all feel. Remind us of the sense of joy that we can all know as we worship, as we make Christingles together. We pray these things in your name. Amen.
Another request for today. After the word shine, I want to hear some really nice woo! Switch out, have a practice. Ready? Shine.
Shine.
Woo! No.
It's rubbish. Shine.
Woo!
Come on, guys. Shine.
Woo!
Now, the good news is there are some shakers left. So, Pat, grab yourself one. And the bad news is I've got a cold, so I need you to sing really nice and loudly because I can't sing today. If you're able to, would you like to stand up at the end of the room?
Break.
sing together. Together we sing. Everyone sing.
Oh, there we go, it's all working. Sorry, I was just too enjoying that, forgotten to put my mic on. Morning, welcome. I'm Lorna. Welcome to the live stream again. Nice to see you. That's the wrong piece I'm looking at. Here we go. So lovely to see you all. If you're new here, you are so welcome. Just enjoy this morning. I hope it's a bit of fun. This is a time for us to be all together, kids, adults, everybody. Normally, we've got little different stations for things to do and different ways to help us connect with God. Today, we kind of sat sort of where we are, and we're going to make these Christingles together, but there will be time to reflect and connect with each other and connect with God. So last time we were all together, we read from a letter in the Bible, and I'm going to get these in the wrong order now, and it was written by a man called Paul, and he planted loads of churches really early on. He was a super church planter. And he wrote this. He said, "But the Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in our lives." And we had all our fruits. Do you remember, kids? We had love. We had joy. We had peace. And patience. And kindness. Goodness. Faithfulness. Gentleness. And self-control. And last time we were all together, our focus was on love. That's one of the fruits of the Spirit. So today we're thinking about joy. And the joy that Jesus brings. It's a great word for Christmas, isn't it? We see a lot of things on our Christmas cards, joy to the world. But what does joy feel like? When do you feel joy? So I just want you to take a moment now. There will be spaces like this, if you're not used to this, just to chat with the people around you. Just take a moment, just have a chat. What brings you joy? What are the things that bring you joy? And when do you feel joy? And what does it feel like? So just take a moment now just to chat with the people around you. Brilliant. I imagine many of you are feeling excited and joyful about Christmas this year. Presents on Christmas Day and being able to see family over Christmas. We are really excited to see our family. We didn't get to see them last year. My family's in Derbyshire and Duncan's family's in Lancashire. So we didn't get to see them last Christmas, and it will be an absolute joy to see them this Christmas. I also imagine that some of you are feeling a little overwhelmed today because there's still so much to be done, right? Presents to still be bought and wrapped and cards to write and be posted and houses to be tidied and food to be bought and loads of stuff at work to complete. So today, I really want there to be I'm hoping there will be some time and some space to breathe and to sense God's joy. Okay, so we have Christingles today. They are all in your bags. There should be enough for four Christingles in each bag, so we might need to just do a little bit of sharing. If you've not got one, there's a bag over here with some in if you've not got one. But there should be enough. So the Christingle tells a wonderful story. Do be careful, there are some sharp items in there. There are some cocktail sticks which are a little bit sharp. And there are some candle holders with a spike on them, so do take care. And the candles are battery candles. Duncan and I spent about a couple of hours last night flipping them open and putting the batteries in. So they should all be safe, but parents, if you've got little children, please just do be aware of those. There are batteries in those. Right. Can I ask you to take another moment to just recall, think about something you have created. It might be a song you have written, a picture you've drawn or painted. It might be a performance that you've done on stage. It might be a home that you've created from a house. Just take a moment to think about something you have created. And I'd love you to think about the joy you felt when you created that. So I'm just going to give you another little moment to chat and think about that joy of creating something. There's a bag here, the front, if you want it. So that sense of joy when you create something. We are going to make the Christingles. I'm going to talk through how we do it. You're very welcome to get on with it, but I am going to talk through it. Right, so let's just start with the orange. If you've not already started. The orange represents the world that God made and everything in it. And he made the world out of love, and it brought him great joy. So just take a moment, just to hold your orange. Oh, I've got mine here. I've got one here, haven't I? To hold your orange and just imagine how God might have felt creating the world. So you can have a chat with the people around you, or you can tell God how you feel about the world, or ask him how he feels about the world he created. So again, just take another moment. It will be noisy this morning. That's fine. Just chat and... So how did God feel when he made the world? Right, the next bit of our Christingle. You need your cocktail sticks. You need four each. There should be more in the bag, so some of them, if they break. And your sweeties. Try and stick two sweets on each of your four cocktail sticks. I'm going to have a go, see if I can not break the cocktail sticks. So these, you might need some help, represent all the good things that God has poured into the world. These represent... I'm struggling. The changing seasons, the plants and the trees and the animals and us, human beings, with all our uniqueness and our diversity and our beauty and our potential. These are all the good things that God has poured into the world. Oops. And I'm struggling a bit. I should have done this before, shouldn't I? I should have put them all on before, like Blue Peter. So as you put these good things, think about all the good things that God has brought into your life that bring you joy. It may be certain people that bring you joy. It may be gifts and talents that God has given you. But just take a moment to think about those. And if you want to, you can just take a moment to thank God for all of those things. So we're going to put the sweets on. I think I've broken that one. Never mind. And then they just stick into your Christingle, like so. So that's the world and all its good things. Okay, the next part of the Christingle is the red tape. And this represents the love and the blood of Jesus who came to bring great joy. You should have some red tape on some laminated sheets. So that should be all ready for you to kind of peel off. There is some more here if anybody's short. And put around your Christingle, like this. And there we go. So the tape, that represents the love and the blood of Jesus. Huh? Slow down. Do I need to slow down? Sorry. So as you put the tape on, just take a moment to think about God's love for you and for the world. If you're not really sure what you think about God, just maybe think about the people who love you and the people who show you love. See, God's love is over everything and above everything. And whatever situation you are in right now or your family is in, God's love is here no matter what. And it wraps around the whole world. You know, if you're facing a difficult situation, why not take a moment now just to ask God where He is in that situation? Right, I'll give you a little moment to finish those bits off. How are we doing? We all managed to get our sweets onto the oranges and the tape round. How are we doing? Do you know, I found the sweets a little bit fiddly because they kept breaking. Do I need to give you all a little bit longer? How we doing? Thumbs up if you've got the red tape on. Thumbs up if you've got your sweets on your sticks that represent all the good things. Are we nearly there? Amazing. Right. Beth's going to come and read a little Bible verse in a moment. You can come up, Beth, and get ready for that. If you need to have a little jump up and down, a little wiggle, then do that now. Have a little jump up and down, a little wiggle, because I know we've just been sat still, haven't we, some of you? So if you need to do that now. Yep, Dave's having a little jump up and down there. Marvellous. Just a wiggle, okay. Okay, we're nearly done with the Christingles. We're just going to hear this little bit from the Bible, so Beth's going to read that for us now.
There were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to to those on whom his favour rests.
Thank you. So, if you've not already done so, and I can see many of you have, we're going to add the last part to our Christingle. So you should have a candle holder and a candle. We thought we'd go battery operated instead of flames and risk, you know, hair being set on fire and things. So the candle holder just goes into the top and then you pop your candle in and you can switch the candles on. So this represents Jesus. The candle represents Jesus, the light of the world. God sent Jesus to bring great joy. Now the angel said, I bring you good news that will cause great joy. And that good news is the news of Jesus. I was thinking about good news and great joy and how they are linked. Good news is actually just news if it happens to someone else, isn't it? So if you read that someone wins this amazing competition, or if somebody else who you don't really know, if they land the perfect job, or some celebrity has this amazing experience, or somebody has the perfect relationship, that's news, right? But if it happens to you or a close friend, that's when it becomes great joy. So the good news of Jesus is great joy for me because it's personal. Because I've accepted that Jesus is the good news and that he has a plan and a purpose for my life and for your life. And that's when the good news becomes great joy. Now, we said that the good news becomes great joy when it becomes personal. But did you also notice what the angel said? He said, I bring you good news that will cause great joy for. Who did he say it would cause great joy for? Was it just for the shepherds? Was it for Mary and Joseph? Actually, what the angel said was, I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. So Jesus is the good news for all people, but you know, there's still a lot of people who do not know that. So many people think that Jesus is just a story and he's irrelevant to life today, and that's not great joy, is it? And the story of the shepherds continues like this. It says, after the shepherds had seen him, that's the baby Jesus, they told everyone. They reported what the angel had said about them, had said about this child. All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. So joy was sent into the lives of the shepherds and they spread it to other people. Okay, I'm nearly done. And we're going to sing a few more songs when I'm finished. So just as we finish now, let's just take another moment to think about how we can spread that good news of Jesus so that it can become great joy for other people. You might want to invite somebody next week so they can come and join with us and be part of our community and celebrate with us with our carols and our no rehearsal nativity. You might just want to find a way to encourage someone this week or spend time with somebody who might be a little bit lonely. You might want to do something kind for your neighbours. You might want to just tell somebody about how the good news of Jesus become great joy in your life. So let's just take a moment now just to think about that. You can have a chat with the people around you. You can chat to God. And then we're going to welcome the band back and we're going to sing another couple of songs. And I also want to say, if you are here today and you don't know the good news of Jesus as great joy in your life, we would love to speak to you afterwards. Duncan and I will be around over here somewhere. Just come find us. We would love to talk to you. All right, just a little moment to think about that great joy, and then we're going to welcome the band back. Amazing. And you can keep all your candles on as we sing. That would be great. Hmm?
Okay, we're going to sing a few songs to end our service. Now we're going to sing O Come All Ye Faithful as the first song, but just as a warning, I don't know, is that the right word? This is a slightly different version of O Come All Ye Faithful. So there is the core of the song in there, and then we're just going to sing some other bits. So don't be surprised when it goes off piste a little bit. So it's all in the spirit of the song. So if you're able to, would you like to stand? Is it's in the wrong key. So we'll try that again, shall we? It's all professional up here, don't worry. I was sitting there thinking, this still feels a bit low. And then I looked at my guitar and went, yeah, that's in the wrong key. Should we try that again? God of God. Better when you play in the right key, right?
No height or depth can separate. Steadfast love we can escape. In your faithfulness, an endless sea. So full of grace and mercy.
Oh, yeah. We're going to sing one more hymn, carol even. I'll get it right in a minute, won't I?
Well done, everybody. I must apologise. I've just realised, for anyone who's a parent in the room, we've just pumped your kids full of E numbers and and expected them to, you know, enjoy the rest of the service. I hope you enjoyed this morning. If you are new and you haven't met Laura and I yet, please come and say hello. We'll be around. If you would like to grab a coffee, that'd be great. If you were listening to Lorna's little talk and was thinking about that joy element and just want to be prayed for joy, again, come and find Lorna and I or anyone who looks like they're nice and ask them. That'd be great. I'm going to pray a blessing over you, and then can we just do that one more time? Is that all right? No, we don't want to do that one again. Sorry, Paul. Yeah, I'll pray a blessing over you. We'll sing one more song, and then we'll go and grab a coffee and have a chat. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you. The Lord be gracious to you. The Lord's favor rest on you. And the name of the Lord be above your household, be above your home, be above your family, all of the days of your life, and particularly during this Christmas, this Advent season. Amen. Paul.
The pastor requested it, we shall do it. Ready?
One.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare. World, the Savior reigns, the sweetest songs in. sounding joy. Repeat the sounding joy.
We seek the light that leads to the light.